1982.
Yeah?
Yeah, 30 years ago now.
Seems like a long time ago, doesn't it?
It's a lifetime ago, yes, absolutely. Yeah. Playing for a little while, and it was someone in the team, I think our team coach or someone like that, sort of said someone should become a referee so we have a better understanding of the rules. And that's how I got into referee.
Yeah.
Well, everything from supervisor through to being president. I was president for 3 or 4 years, I think 3 years. I was a VBRA delegate. I was vice president, supervisor, appointments officer. I held a number of different positions over a number of years.
Yeah.
And I guess it's like today, the retention of referees is a difficult process, particularly when you take them at 14 or 15, and then they get to that 17, 18, they're doing their VCE, thinking about uni, girlfriends, boyfriends. Time doesn't spread that far, and it's always been a great loss at that VCE, 17, 18 year old range. One of the satisfactions was to see those that worked their way through that process and came out and continued to referee, your Chris Reeds, your Wendy Barnards, people like that that have come through. Another great inspiration for us too, particularly with Keith Bourne as the advisor, because he was mainly the advisor when I was there and I was assisting him, was some of the others that we coached as referees that weren't fully able-bodied or mind. There was a young lass who was intellectually impaired, but we were able to, it was a very mild intellectual impairment, and it was at a point where Keith, more than me, but Keith was the main instigator, actually got her through the school and on court as a referee. You had the likes of Neil Black, who only had one arm,
right?
Modified signals, things like that, but came through, ended up being a referee's coach and doing senior basketball. Fantastic. So it was great to see the kids when they came in at 14 or 15, timid, unsure of themselves, lacking self-confidence, and once they got through the school and they became familiar with being a referee, the difference, the confidence, and the, you know, it was good. It was very pleasing. A lot of personal satisfaction. Knox, look, the people, always the people, the youth, the young people, and some of the older people, because I was there with Bev and Stag, Stan Agenbar, Fred Jago, Alice Jago, Arthur Manton, and all of those were all good. Neil Quinn, Graham Wright, people that aren't even here tonight. It was good. We got along. We all had a common interest, common goal. We worked well together, and we got along. I remember even on the court, Arthur and I remembered earlier tonight, I was playing against him. And I was getting in his way, I was defending him too well, and he's bigger than me, as I was then, and he quite literally just picked me up and said, get out of the way. And I turned around to, I think it was John Borgman at the time, as a referee, said, foul ref, and he didn't see a thing. But that's the way it goes, but that's what it was like in those days. It was many, many years ago. It's very different now. But yeah, look, it's really the people make or break any situation. And a great bunch. Basketball people are great people. Mm. Yeah. That's difficult because I'm not directly involved with the branch now as much as I would have liked to have been because of my overseas work, so I've not been around.
Okay.
But on these two or three occasions where I've come together with the likes of yourself and other current referees and past referees, it seems to me one of the interesting observations is the youth of those or in those who are administering the branch. As I said, I mean, we were people in our 30s and 40s and 50s who were managing the branch in our day. But I see the youth of, you know, mid to late 20s. Now, you have a look at, you know, The President Sean and the others, yourself, you're on these committees. We didn't have people this young on our committees, right? It was incredibly rare. We were much more mature and older people who were managing it. And that, to me, is really inspiring and promising for the future, that young people like yourself are taking on positions of responsibility to ensure the future of the association.
Exactly.
Right? So that's the brilliance of it, that you've come through as a referee and you've seen the benefits of it, and you're going to make sure it ensures by giving back, you know, through being a member of the committee.
Exactly.
And it does, to me, of course, seem more professional, in so much as, well, we didn't have the IT ability that you have now, and so you've got your computer programs for your rostering and all of that, and you know what's been going on there, because back in the 80s we didn't have IT facilities as such. That's all being taken there. You've got your Facebook pages and all of that. So it's interesting to see that the association is keeping pace with general society, I think, because that's what needs to happen.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't live in the past in this process. It's got to be dynamic. It's got to be moving forward. It's got to stay in touch with the current youth. And I think from where I stand, you guys and the rest of you seem to be doing that really, really well.
Yeah.
You know, I think one of my greatest achievements on court, if I can put it in this terms, was the night a guy came on and I was sure he was absolutely drunk. He'd had too much before he even got there. It was a hot summer's night, he'd had too much to drink, but nobody had challenged him coming into the venue. I talked him through that game, and he was so drunk, he fell over two or three times without anyone touching him, but I just talked him through the game and kept him out of trouble. All right? I recognised the situation, I dealt with it, I managed it, and just through words, he got through 40 minutes of basketball and we parted friends. That, to me, was great. Keith Vaughan, without a doubt. Without a doubt, Keith. Absolutely.
Was that because he was the advisor?
Well, he was the advisor, but he was always... No. He was... just his approach. Neil Bradbury, Jeff Hunt, all the others around at different times. But Keith's down to earth, realistic, and interested in the individual. And that came through with me. It got me. So yeah, Keith Vaughan. Oh, crikeys. I'm an old school, so my advice probably isn't current. Enjoy it. Consistency, we talked about that. You know, set your standard early and be consistent. Because it doesn't matter if you're consistently right or consistently wrong. Then the players will play to that consistency and you'll be in less trouble. But hey, it's a game. Enjoy it and give it your best shot. You know, don't be a lazy ref. Don't be slack, because you're out there doing something, and you should be proud of what you're doing and give it your best. Do your best to do it, you know. Be proud of what you're doing and do your best all the time. Doesn't matter whether it's a round robin game or a grand final. It's a game, and the players deserve to be given your full attention. That's where it's at.